Markets like to be free, but after the financial crisis, that freedom is increasingly being curbed. Regulators across the world are now ready to control capital flows that can destabilize economies.
Adair Turner, you've been asking for a tax on speculative capital flows across different countries. Now, how successful will this be in ensuring that there is financial stability?
The fact is, a financial transactions tax is one among the ideas that many economists have proposed over the years, and it reflects the fact that there is some measure of some part of financial activity, speculative activity, which is not economically value-added and is simply producing volatility in markets. And if you can have a small tax on that, there are two possibilities. Either it won't change at all, but you'll have the tax revenue, and it'd be a better tax than taxing people's labour, or it might very slightly damp it down. I certainly don't think it is a panacea. I think it may well not be something which can be agreed on an international level. I don't know whether that's possible. But I do think it's odd that we developed a period of time, we developed a point of view that you simply had to exclude these options even from consideration. And that reflected the fact that we were over in love with trading activity for its own sake. There are other ways of achieving the same effect, and I've always been clear that the primary tool we will use in this area is better capital requirements, higher capital requirements against trading activity.
You've also been arguing that lending and borrowing should be made more tougher so that people only borrow what they actually need. Now, what are the steps that are required for this?
If credit is extended to people who are either buying houses or a developing real estate, who know that they wouldn't be able to pay for it out of the cash flow, but simply are part of an asset price bubble, that is immensely disruptive as well as very dangerous for banks. And there are techniques that we can use on that. So in the housing market, you can require lenders to do real assessments of affordability, and that's what we will do. In the commercial real estate market, I've raised the issue of whether we should be more willing to vary the capital requirements against commercial real estate on a cyclical basis through the cycle to slow down excessive lending in that sector.
Financial activity can't be unfettered anymore. Lord Turner is setting the example by tightening lending and borrowing norms for individuals and corporations in UK. Expect other regulators in other countries to follow suit.